My mom told me a long time ago, and it stuck with me, if you're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem. As I've grown older, I realized that if you're not part of the solution, you are the problem. Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and friends. Those of you that know me know that I have a passion for young people. I will give my all, and then my husband's all, to do what needs to be done to help young people. I have been blessed in the last 6 months or so to work with two different types of young people, same ages, with the same goals. But my experience with them has been extremely different. And I want to use the next 5 to 7 minutes to share that with you. My first group, and I'm going to call them City A. I won't use names to protect the innocent. City A is a group 10 to 18 years of age, leaders in their own right, and are seeking to perfect their leadership and public speaking skills. I have been charged with helping them do that. So, I figure as a 57-year-old, I might have a little bit I could share with them. As a Toastmaster, I knew I had a lot I could share with them. Because I'm a dawn breaker, okay? And I know a little bit. So, I meet with these young people every week, and we sit down, and we talk, and we share. And they are extremely energetic. They do their assignments, and they're just waiting for the next assignment. Now, City B, same age, same objective, totally different approach. I sit with these young people every day, 2 hours a day. Every day. I walk in, I say, good morning, how are you? Okay, let's try that again. Good morning, how's everyone? Happy to be alive? Yeah, maybe, so what? Okay, are we ready to learn something today? No answer. Are we gonna do the mission today? No answer. So I got a little frustrated, and I said, okay, this is my opportunity to interact with these young people. What is it that you want to achieve? No one said they wanted to be a leader. I want to be a barber. I want to be a beautician. I want to go to school, but I haven't quite learned I don't know what school I'm going to. I just want to hang out. I said, okay, but we're going to help you find out what it is you want to do. Yeah, okay. So when I went home after a couple of weeks, I'm saying, why is it so different? I have the same type of young people, same age, and based on the information I got from their coordinators, had the same objectives in mind, what they wanted to achieve. But not the case. Pet peeve number one for me, and please excuse me for using pet peeve, but this is a pet peeve of mine. My young men in City B, they walk in with their pants down to here. And I say, young men, I am not interested in what color underwear you have on, nor whether you have on any at all. Okay? What I am interested in is you pulling up your pants and putting a belt to them. If you cannot do that, I will facilitate that for you. You would think after one time they'd get the message and that'd be a done deal. No. The next day they come in with their pants down to here and a shirt down to here. I said, whoa, do I look stupid? Do you think that I cannot tell that you have on pants below your behind? Well, you said, I said, and then I reiterated. My point, why do I have to go through this with leaders? Now, my city A, they come in, they sit down, they're dressed, they look like young people. So why am I sharing this with you? I'm sharing this with you because I want to be part of the solution. I don't want to be the one that says, well, she don't care, she can't hear us, she doesn't understand what we're talking about. But I do want to be the one that say, you know what, you need to rethink what you're doing. You need to understand the origin of what you're doing. I want you to be successful. But honestly, I'm looking at City B, they have a long way to go. City A is focused and on target. What do I do? Do I throw in the towel on City B and say, hey, throw up my hands, I'm through with this? My mind and my heart says absolutely not. They're going to get tired of me saying pull up your pants. They're going to get tired of me saying be respectful. They're going to get tired of me asking them, what are you going to do when you grow up, if you grow up? They're going to get tired of that one day. My point is my responsibility to make sure that our young people have a venue. Regardless of how frustrated I might get, and regardless how angry it makes me that they make some of the decisions that they make, they are 10 to 18. I'm 57. They have a little longer to make it okay. It's my responsibility to make sure they have a venue to make it okay. So when you hear me grumble, it's because I haven't figured out how I'm going to do it yet. But be assured, I'm there for the long haul. They might get tired of me, but they certainly will know Mrs. Smith Sellers. Thank you.